I need to lighten it up, actually, before I say this. The great High Chief Peter Maivia. He was many things to a lot of people, but to my family, he was everything. He was compassionate, was loving, fierce, extraordinarily loyal. He was a warrior who loved this business, loved his family even more. My grandfather's integrity in this business was unparalleled. When my family reflect on him, we discuss the fact that he had such a great effect on people's lives, all the lives that he touched. He was truly a man who was universally loved and respected. His matches were historic, working with such greats as the great Harley Race, Chief Jay Strongbow, superstar Billy Graham, Bob Backlund, and of course in San Francisco, his matches with Pat Patterson were the matches that dreams were made of. My grandfather had immeasurable charisma. He charmed people all over the world, whether he was a strong baby face or a very vicious heel. When I think of him, I can't help but think of the special quality that he had. He had a great spirit to him. He had a warrior spirit to him. My grandfather was a paramount high chief who had tattoos from the bottom of his chest all the way down to his knees, 360 degrees. It's very similar to what I have tattooed on my arms and my chest now. My grandfather was known as one of the toughest men in this business ever. But what set him apart, he was the kindest. And for those of you who don't know, he was extremely kind. And for those of you who do know him, you can attest to this. Let's take a look at my grandfather, the great High Chief, Peter Maivia.
Chief Peter Maivia erupted onto the wrestling scene during the 1960s and 70s, dominating the territories of New Zealand, Hawaii, and San Francisco.
My grandfather was the first Samoan wrestler to become known on a worldwide basis.
First time that I seen him wrestle, it was like I was hooked from that point on.
High Chief Peter Maivia, oh my God, what an unbelievable performer.
There we see the Samoan stump puller, and it's all over.
And you didn't want to mess with him.
Chief Peter Maivia was probably one of the toughest guys out there.
Man, I used to be so afraid. I swear to God, every time I wrestled Peter Maivia, I would shake before I'd go in the ring. I never knew if I was going to come back alive.
While his prowess was legendary, it was Maivia's pride in his Samoan heritage that truly made him stand out.
That culture has produced so many superstars, yet definitive warriors.
There have just been so many great Samoans from that same bloodline. They're crucial in the history of WWE.
My dad took the name Samoa all over the world. He was the first Samoan to do that.
Peter Maivia was a real Samoan chief.
As is one proud Samoan in a real roughhouse.
He was like our Muhammad Ali.
He put Samoa on the map.
The WWE Hall of Fame proudly welcomes the forefather of Samoan wrestling, the High Chief, Peter Maivia.
Aloha!
Before we go on, I have to introduce someone. His wife, my grandmother, Leah Maivia. Please stand up, Grandma. My grandmother, who just turned 80 years old this year, Sorry, Grandma. Sorry, sorry. 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 Easy. Easy. Who gave my grandmother whiskey? Easy. My grandmother, who just turned 80 this year, was one of the very first female promoters in our world of professional wrestling and sports entertainment. It was those images that we just saw of my grandfather and his amazing performances and his magnetic personality that inspired me to be part of this business. They inspired me to become a professional wrestler. My dad and my grandfather are the cornerstones of my career. And when that dream came true, when I stepped in the WWE ring for the first time in 1996, my sole purpose at that time was to just make my family proud. From my mom, to my dad, to my grandmother, to Danny. To our little girl, Simone, I've always asked the question. My final question is this, is Grandpa, as Grandpa, I hope I've made you proud. Because I sure am so proud of you. I usually get $15 million to cry in movies. I needed that, thank you. To induct my grandfather into the 2008 WWE Hall of Fame, please welcome the real rock of the family, my mom, his daughter, Atta Johnson.
Thank you, son. First, I want to say that I've been around the wrestling business now for almost 50 years. I'm used to being on that side of the stage. So when my son asked me to speak on behalf of my mother, in honor of my father, my first reaction was, no way, that'll never happen. If I can't speak or talk about my father without getting emotional in front of my own family and friends, how can I possibly do it in front of 10,000 people? Let alone millions. Thank you. 10,000 people, let alone millions and millions. Thank you. Millions on TV. Yet here I am. I have asked my son to stand by just in case, and I hope you'll understand if I get emotional and falter. It's a wonderful thing about the wrestling grapevine of wrestlers and their families. No matter where you go or what you do, somebody always knows how so-and-so is doing. And when we see each other, no matter how many years have passed, it's as if we were on the road together just yesterday. From here, It's great to see dear faces that I haven't seen in years, and you all look so fabulous. Yes, you do. My father, High Chief Peter Fanene Leifi Maivia, used to preach in the little church that he and my mother helped to build in a little town called Tokoroa in New Zealand. Their names as founders are still engraved in the cornerstone of that little church. When my father broke into the business by way of promoter Steve Ricard in New Zealand, in Auckland, New Zealand, I was just 10 years old. When we left for Europe in the early 60s, people there just didn't know how to take this big, happy, smiling fella with the long, curly hair and the colorful skirt. In Samoa, it's a lava lava, but in England, it was half a dress. And the other English word for dress is frock. So many times, I'd want to come out swinging. I was 16. When I would hear, "Call blimey, that bloke's in a frock." Well, ladies and gentlemen, the man in that frock was the toast of Europe. It was there that my father met greats like George Gorienko, Gordon Nelson, Billy Robinson, Andre Bolle, Paul Vachon, to name a few. Yes. And it was in Paris that we first met a very tall, lanky young wrestler just starting out. Later on, he became famous as Andre the Giant. We left Europe for New Zealand in 1968, and we stopped over in Hawaii. The rest was history. Here in Hawaii, my father met a prince, a king, and a lord. Prince Nef Maiva, King Curtis Yokea, and Lord Tally Ho Blairs.